Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba I am busy tomorrow night, so I am unable to stream at my normal time, which means I am going to be streaming tonight.
Able to stream at my normal
Oh
time.
no, what's going on here?
Which means I am
Should
going to be streaming tonight.
probably close that. Oh, there we go. So anyway, let's just get rid of all that crap. Right. Close that. Here we go. Let's get streaming. So as is customary for these sorts of things, I am busy spreading the word and letting people know that the stream is live, and I hope to get, oh, I don't know, maybe three, four people viewing before I launch tonight's game, which is Uriel's Chasm 2, the sequel that nobody asked for. The very first game that I ever streamed was Uriel's Chasm. It was a horrible, horrible game. One of the first comments that anyone posted on one of my streams was for Uriel's Chasm 2. Sorry, not Uriel's Chasm 2, the first Uriel's Chasm. And they said, this stream is giving me ear cancer. That was largely down to the fact that the sound was so unbelievably loud. Sorry, you have to excuse me. I'm like a typical Englishman making some tea. Drink up. It's the rather delicious Pukka Three Cinnamon Tea. I'm not sponsored by Pukka, they're not paying me for this. I wish they were, or at least sending me free tea. So if I could get a sponsorship deal from the Pukka tea manufacturers, or from Nong Shim, the company that makes shin cup instant noodle pot things, that would be awesome because, like, every day at work, I eat a shin cup and it's the most delicious thing. It's the best of, the instant cup noodles. So Nong Shim, if there's anyone from Nong Shim watching this, you want me to plug your products every single stream, that's getting the word out to at least 10, maybe even 20 people if I hit the big time. I really think you'd see a massive sales increase. Or anyone else wants to sponsor me. I'm willing to be a complete whore. But unlike other YouTubers, I'm going to be honest about it and say these guys are sponsoring me, so you should eat the stuff, rather than pretending that it's my own opinion, like pretty much all other YouTubers do. So anyway, it's 7:29. I had planned to start at 7:30. I've got three people viewing. Let me just have a look at the thing. Right, okay, so yeah, the can you TLDR the story for Uriel's Chasm 1 so we don't get lost with the plot? The story was something something Bible, something something space, something 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 massive giant space giraffe. And at the end, yeah, so at the end of Uriel's Chasm 1, there was some horrible bullet hell section where I had to completely destroy a giant space giraffe. And then, as soon as I did it, the words "the end" appeared on the screen, and some subpar Marilyn Manson style pseudo industrial music played. And the only way to exit the game was to Alt F4. I've had a quick play around just to test the sound levels, because the sound levels in Uriel's Chasm 1 were so unbelievably atrocious. That it, you know, it messed up the stream for the first 20 minutes. So what I've done this time is I've just loaded up the game and I've tested it. And you know, it's so rubbish. I don't know how the game actually reports itself as a winner. Normally I have the capture device set up to capture full screen windows, but Uriel's Chasm doesn't seem to register as a full screen window. So what I've had to do is capture the entire desktop, and I've set up some hotkeys so you don't actually see all of my desktop while I'm switching between the games. So that's going to be it's going to be fun. I've got four people watching the stream. That's cool. Considering I sent out, like, you know, 50 million invites. Now I'm using the I don't know if you can see that there. That's the gaming.youtube.com interface on my tablet. That's how I'm viewing the chat stream there. I'm hoping that'll be easier for me to read, but obviously I can't look at the screen and at the chat at the same time, and I'm not rich enough to have two monitors because I'm only a teacher. Uriel's Chasm 2, very special thanks to Southend Busker for giving me the game. I didn't actually have to pay the £3.99 that it costs. Let's just remember that price, £3.99. That's how much this game actually costs were you to pay full price. So I got it for free. So if you think maybe my opinion might be biased because I got it for free, then, you know, take that into account. But I'm certainly not going to be as biased as IGN allegedly are. I have not just one key to activate Uriel's Chasm, but I have like four spares. So you know what I'm going to do later on in the stream? I'm going to have a giveaway. So that you guys, should you be desperate to play this game, can get a free copy. Or if you want a copy to give to your loved ones for Christmas, or as is probably more appropriate, your most hated enemies, there will be some keys for you to win. I don't know what where are Anita's bees means. I assume it's something about ethics in games journalism. Right, I've got six people watching the stream. And to answer the question, someone's just asked in the feed here, can we opt out of the giveaway? No, you cannot. If you're watching this stream, you are part of the giveaway, whether you like it or not. If necessary, I will track you down and I will force you to enter this key in your Steam account. If necessary, I will hack your Steam account simply to add this game to it. So I think that's probably enough for me. So fingers crossed everything works, and the slight bug with the full screen issue won't be too much of a problem. So here we go. Uriel's Chasm 2. It's got a Hebrew subtitle, but I can't read Hebrew, so I don't know how you pronounce the words. I assume it's something like shitty or something like that. I totally made that up. I have no idea. I've known nothing about the game. Literally all I've done is loaded it up. It's the sequel that nobody asked for, the sequel that nobody wants, and the sequel that we are all about to watch. So without further ado, Uriel's Chasm 2, The Search for Curly's Gold. Okay. All right, so if you remember the first game, and let's say, who doesn't remember the first game, it was set up so that it looks kind of like a hacked... They set it up as a sort of snakes on the plane. Oh, look, we're doing this ironically. We're making an ironically crap game. So that I'm actually this the sound in my ears is really loud. It should be okay for you guys, but I'm actually having to turn the volume on my headset down for fear of contracting ear cancer. It's saying connect Ethernet now. I'm not sure what that means. Oh, well, okay. So yeah, so on the screen there you can see that's the Hebrew. If there's any Jews watching that can translate this, or you know, Marcus Brody or Dr. Henry Jones Jr., if you can translate that for me, then by all means. So I've got two options. I've got start game or options. This music really isn't pleasant. I'm just gonna turn that down even more. Right, so let's go to options, see what options we've got. Okay. Rebind. We've got rebind, BGM, which I can't... Oh, no. Okay, so there's 9 different background musics, which implies there's probably 9 levels. Although the background music number 8... Oh, no, it's there. Who knows? Rebind. Whoa, right, okay. Up. Keyboard controls hack! Okay. Right, rebind controls. Up, down, left, right, fire. Bomb. That's a new one. I just see standard. Up, down, left, right, side. Oh, right, it's gone back to it. Credits. Should we view the credits? Let's see. Graphics was done by Dial. OST. OST? On screen. Trauma. All right. That's done by Dial. Graphics again by Patton. Good old Patton. Dev. Devo. Dial again. And FMV. There's full motion video in this game. Wow, that's interesting. MKS. Now, it says Patreons here, which implies that this game had some sort of financial backing from a community. I assume they're like a community of masochists. I'm not sure why anyone would want like a sequel to this made. Yeah, okay, right. So, I've got a couple of messages here. This could be from potential viewers, so I'm just gonna check. Good, 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 good. Okay, so... it looked like it had 2 Patreon backers, so there's 2 people who obviously hate life. I don't know how I actually get back out of the credits. Oh, there we go, it's done. Right, okay. I guess we should just start the game. Let's go for it. Feel free to comment in the live chat on whatever you see. So here we go, start the game. You have been with me many years, coat of skins. You are like a daughter to me. I think you are ready to know how you came to be a steward of this floating frame, the importance of the water you swim in, and the water that swims in you. Well, none of that made any sense whatsoever. Well, I suppose at least it's not a Bible quote. The other one was full of Bible quotes, wasn't it? So I guess that's something. Okay, I'm supposed to press something? There we go. It started with the amniotic lens! Of course it did. Everything starts with the amniotic lens. One day I found you collapsed in the rope between the multiverse. The nightmarish scaffold you found here has come to be known by you as the dry, waterless place of the Bible! Oh, God. So yeah, okay, we're back to the Bible again. An unfurnished but nevertheless prepared frame. None of this makes any sense. Prepared by us, the abstraction. By grace, I accepted you as a goodwill offering, a sacrifice, and placed you in this garden to work. To water this place, cultivate a garden paradise that would be pleasing in my eyes. Is this supposed to be the word of God? Is this God communicating to us right now? Okay, so, oh God, there's more of this. Unknown to us, antimatter instances of humanity across the multiverse have foretold of this day. This sounds like the preamble to a Voyager episode. You know, this is Harry Kim talking to Tom Paris. He's always seemed like a daughter. Through a strange prophecy, they've got blah, 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 blah. Matter and antimatter can never meet outside the frame. Okay, whatever. Right, well, that sets up the get dried off. Steady on, mate. Wasn't that exciting? Oh, okay, right. Here we go. Okay. Good. What's that dude? Can I shoot that dude? No! Ah! It's shooting fruit at me. I don't know what happened there. There's a risk meter. Oh. Oh, wait. It's got... It's got some sort of graze mechanic. I don't know if any of you guys have played like Japanese bullet hell shooters like 12 Stag. But they have a mechanic called graze where you get bonus points for not getting hit by the bullets, but narrowly avoiding them. So... And you lose the bonus if you get hit, obviously. So you see my graze increasing? I don't know if that actually... Okay, at the moment it's not too bad. I mean, low-res graphics and everything. I'm not actually sure if I'm actually doing any damage, though, or... But... Oh, check that out! Rainbow, goal in! All the rotations. Oh, that wasn't too bad. What a strange dream, that lightning bolt. You know, there's one thing that really, really narks me off. It's people that write lightning instead of lightning. Do you know why? Because they're idiots. That lightning bolt must have knocked me out. Okay. Why'd you torment me so with these electrical storms, father? I guess all I know of this life is the garden. These dreams and these damn storms, putting out fires and gathering fruit. To be fair, that's an alright kind of life, you know? You should try being a teacher. Say something! Exclamation mark on the another line. Please? Oh, right. Okay, I can move around. Okay, pressing Z causes all these little blue things to... What am I... Oh, am I supposed to put out the... Ah, there we go. Obviously supposed to find the trees that are on fire. Put them out. Wait, am I out of water? You cannot be serious. I think I'm actually out of water now. Fire wins. What? What am I supposed to do here? I've got no control over the water. Pressing Z does nothing now. I've obviously run out of water. I don't know how to collect more. Ah, there we go. Refill units by here. Okay, whatever that means. There we go. Okay. That's enough. I'm getting hit by fire. Why are you... No! Nah, man, you've got to be kidding me. At least the first game let me retry the level. No, that cannot be the end. That's the end. You got to do the entire game on a single life with no instructions whatsoever. Ah, right. Okay, right. Let's go again. Don't care about any of that crap. First level wasn't too bad. Let's just keep hammering this thing. We can graze past the fruit. Why is a giant, like, you know, space fish throwing fruit at me? Yeah! Fruit power! Motherfunker! How you like them apples, literally? There we go, goal in. First level's easy. Right, okay. I don't care about that. At least I kind of know what I'm doing now, so I've got to wait for battle. Okay. Let's go. Oh god, I'm out of water again. Oh, I see. You just stand there and then it increases. OK. Okay. I'm not sure if there's any strategy other than like you're filling up your water and then like totally and emptying it around the tree. Oh, that's getting a bit risky now. This game is totally made in like some game maker point and click thing. Remember click and play? Remember click and play? VGA. Oh, what? Oh, hang on, I might have to actually turn the volume up for this. This is one of those fabled FMV sections. Really? What the hell was that? Oh, right, okay, well, those first two, they weren't too bad. Cool. If you're just joining us, this is Uriel's Chasm 2. The sequel to one of the terrible games that I've been subjecting myself to. At the moment, it doesn't seem as bad as the first one. There's less Bible crap. It's pretty straightforward gameplay. It seemed a bit harsh when I died and immediately went back to the title screen, but you know. So here we go. Incoming message. Oh my god. And in process of time, it came to pass that Cain brought. This is more Bible stuff, isn't it? The fruit of the ground, blah, blah, blah. I'm not entirely sure what this has to do with anything. There doesn't seem to be any real consistency between it. Also, there's not really any sort of tie-ins to the first game. It's like one of those sequels that is like a sequel in name only. Like that film, Troll 2. You ever watched Troll 2? It's not actually any trolls in it. It's all goblins. And it's called Troll 2. It's nothing to do with the first film. Great film. And when I say great, it's like, you know, one of the worst films ever made, but it's hilariously bad. So yeah. Right, let's see what happens now. Warning, a huge antimatter tribute is here. Oh, it's another boss. Guessing it's just the same old... Yeah, graze past the fruit. Come on, where's my graze bonus? I'm not sure what they... See, there's like three... Oh god, I totally wasn't looking. And now I've... That's the end as well, isn't it? That's the end. I've got to do all that. I've got to do all that again. I've got to do all that again. Please don't take me back to the credits. This is going to get really tedious really quick. Right, okay. Yeah, we've done this. Want to get that super. Oh yeah! Gay fuel, baby! Oh, I've lost it already. I actually lost a life there because I was trying to look at the UI on that side of the screen and not actually paying attention to what I'm doing. Ah, good, right. I think this is supposed to look like, I don't know, halfway between a Mega Drive and an Amiga game. I think that was the look they were going for. Do I have, like... I have... Oh, God. It's shared lives across all of the different mini-games, isn't it? So... I've got, like, one life left, and then I'm going to die again and go back to the thing, and I'm going to get bored... Oh god, I've got no lives now. I'm gonna take like one hit on that stupid boss level, and then. Come on. Come on, man. Don't care about that. I don't know what that means, get dried off. Not entirely sure what the risk meter means as well. Yeah, never seen me play a game this terribly. Mate, you should see what the controls are like in this game. It's like totally unresponsive, and you can never tell when anything's actually going to hit you. I'm hoping if I can just, like, keep up the pressure on these fire things. It's like they seem to jiggle around randomly. But if I piss water all over the place, then hopefully stop the trees. Oh, did I? How did I get hit then? I literally just got struck by lightning. Oh, I see. Collecting the fruit actually advances it. I thought the way to advance the goal track was to, like, you know, save the trees, but it's just collect the fruit, so I might as well just, like, sack off everything else. There you go. Why didn't I just do that in the first place? Oh, and here's that creepy full motion video again. Right, okay. Another boss battle. Here we go. Now, just to remind you as well, I'm deliberately putting myself in harm's way because you get the bonus for grazing the bullets. So, like, I'm actually not trying to... Well, I'm trying to avoid them, but trying to avoid them by as small a margin as possible. That's probably why I keep getting hit. Maybe I should just, like, try and avoid it in the hopes of actually finishing the game. But, I mean, that was uncalled for, wasn't it? Right, okay, new strategy. Now, I know the secret to the second level, so I'll be able to blast through that no problem. Let's go again, let's go again. How long have I been on for? About half an hour. Now, it took me an hour to finish the first game, and that had, what, four levels. But that reset you to the start of the level that you failed, rather than just dropping you straight back to the title screen as soon as you die. Yeah, suicide would be a pretty good strategy, Lorcan. Oh, God, I just drove into that, didn't I? And you get that superpower and you don't really have the opportunity to use it because, like, the thing's out of the way, and if you try and hit it, you just put yourself in harm's way. What does the 666 thing mean as well? And what do those three, like, fruit icons at the side actually mean? All these answers and many, many more you will never actually find the answers to. Welcome to the stream, Varian. Glad you could join us. Right, let's... Oh, come on! There's one piece of fruit, finally. There's another piece of fruit. Should I even bother trying to save these trees? Oh, yeah, because the lightning just strikes, doesn't it? Just like in real life. It's lightning all over the place. I think the lightning's supposed to be God or something. Proof that God's a bit of a prick. I died, and that was probably because I was rushing. So, once again, will we ever see the last levels? Who knows? Let's try again. Because nothing says great game design like, sending you right back to the very start after unfairly killing you. I suppose maybe I should just, man up and get good. And I wouldn't mind if it was, an actual fun game to play, but it's not really that good. I mean, it's all right, I guess. Ah, I know what those 666 things are. That's my bombs. So maybe I should use them instead of dying all the time. It's the only game where you have to be mad. Yeah, well, no, Uriel's Chasm 1, you have to be pretty mad as well. Right, okay, let's go back down here. Let's fill up the water. Remember, guys, we're collecting the fruit. It doesn't really matter about the trees, but God, in his infinite wisdom, wants to destroy all trees because he's an idiot. So that's generally the gist of it. Look at those graphics as well. I mean, this is, real. It's a good job I'm streaming in 720p. Because otherwise you'd miss all the nuances of the textures. What hit me then? What hit me? Nothing. Okay. Oh, got a carrot. Just refill the water. There we go. That level wasn't so bad. You thought? What did that even say? Yeah, and I've seen this crap found footage thing like 5 times now. Right, here we go. Incoming message once again. Those of you that are just joining us, there's these crap messages. They're mostly like Bible verses. In some way, this game relates to the Bible, but I'm not entirely sure how. And as soon as you die, it drops you straight back to the thing. There's no sort of continues or anything like that. So here we go. Let's see if I can't actually kill this guy. What the hell? One life left, and I'm totally not going to do this now because he's cheating! God damn you! Yeah! This is the furthest I've ever got. And now I've got no lives. And I've got to do this again! Are you kidding me? This game is just going to follow the same pattern, isn't it? It's going to be one of those stupid bosses. It's going to be this save the trees crap where you just get hit by a random moving piece of fire. What could these dreams mean? Are not my own offerings of fruit good enough for you, Father? Sometimes I wish I could see you, hear you even. Yeah, but you can't. Do you know why you can't? Father! Father! Good. Now what? Oh, it's the same old shite. Except I've only got one life and I'm totally going to die. I just need... Give me some fruit. You got no control over the water, where it goes. Oh, there's a piece of fruit. I think this game was written by an arsehole. By arseholes, for arseholes. Oh no! The tree died! If I cared, I might be sad. But. Just give me the fruit, goddammit. Right, I need two more pieces of fruit. Oh no! Where did that even come from? What does print screen hack mean as well? What does that mean? WWE Raw, please subscribe me. I need plus 100 subscribers. Yeah. Don't tell me to calm down either. If you were forced to play this game, you'd know the rage. You'd know the rage. Right, okay, here we go again. Start the game. Get dried off. That's what I always say to people before they enter battle. Just get dried off, guys. I especially like the lazy animation on the boss, the way it doesn't actually have any frames of animation, it just moves backwards and forwards, with that sort of like thought applied to it. This game's sort of teaching me that fruit is bad. You know, I'm learning to hate fruit because fruit seems to kill me. There we go, golden. Yeah, well, I see some people have watched my other videos. That's great. What a strange dream, that lightning bolt. Yeah, okay, right, here we go. So the purpose of this bit is to pick up all the bits of fruit, and God is continually setting fire to trees, and you can't really put out the fires particularly well. All you can do is like spill a load of water all over the floor, and you have to keep coming down here to collect new water. So there's one piece of fruit, so I've got to get all of the fruit. There we go. Okay. Alright, let's go up here. Hit by that fire again because it's pretty unavoidable, and the lightning just seems to happen randomly. How many lives have I got left? 2. I don't even know if you can actually gain extra lives, or hope you can. Oh god. Oh, carrot, which I know technically isn't fruit, but what are you gonna do? Alright, there we go. Good. You start to prophecy. Whatever that means. Yes. Yeah, the chat's kind of degenerated into something a bit rubbish, hasn't it? I might have to start banning people. And I died. I wonder if there's any cheats for this game. I just want to see what's past that thing. I don't know if it's Enola Gay by OMD. It might be. Good, okay. So yeah, there's There's no more game modes than this. Here we go. See, the problem with this is that it's an all or nothing thing. If you're forced to continually repeat the level that you can't do, then you get gradually better at that level, I guess. But if you're forced to repeat the entire game, you end up getting, I guess, pretty good at the early bits, but you never really progress towards the more difficult parts towards the end. Right, okay, here we go. Oh, that's a carrot. Good start, off to a good start. See, I'm trying to see the positive in this. Someone must have spent, about half an hour making this game. I doubt they spent any time testing it. To be fair, though, it's pretty bug-free. You know, I've not had any sort of, quality assurance issues. It's just not a very good game. You know, it's like a bit dull. Right, okay, so what would I rate this game out of 10? I don't like giving games scores out of 10 because I don't believe that any game can have an absolute score. If you say, oh, this is a 9 out of 10 game, then it puts it on some sort of scale. And I think every game has at least something going for it. And also certain games appeal to different people more. So I think, generally speaking, when magazines and review sites give games scores out of 10, it's to the detriment of the game. Especially because most scores are really skewed towards the upper end of the scale now. So, if a game gets 7, it's seen as bad, man. It's like, but 7 should mean, pretty good, actually, especially for fans of the genre. An average game should be 5 out of 10. And a bad game should be less than 5, you see. So it's sort of skewed. So I don't like to review games on an absolute score thing. I'm trying to see the good in it. The art style isn't too bad on the screen like this. It's not that bad. I mean, the wandering around saving the trees thing is a bit rubbish. It's got a kind of a cool retro vibe. The play style, it's like sort of a fairly standard bullet hell shooter sort of thing. Not too dissimilar to sections in Undertale. In fact, the actual bullet hell is probably better than the bullet hell in Undertale, which I might actually cop some flack for saying, but, But it's just, the game just lacks something. It's just not fun. It feels like a chore. Boss is nearly dead. Here we go. Yeah! Yeah, that's not too bad. Hold on a sec. Oh, come on. Cranked out by Shoot 'em Up Construction Kit sounds about right. Here we go. What else could these dreams mean? So I've got to go through this contemptible section again. I don't know if the fire gets more aggressive, if that's a thing that fire does. Um, The lightning bolts seem to be more frequent. Shite. It looks like I've already lost one of the trees. I'm down to my last life as well. I just hope I can get past this bit. Just simply so I can see the next bit. That's all I really care about. I just want to see what happens next. I don't even care that much about... Hey, okay. Oh, it's another prophecy. Another amazing piece of found footage. Filmed in an NCP car park, probably. So the 666 is the smart bombs that you've got. And I agree. The problem with that the overland levels where you've got to save the tree is that's all there is to it. It's not a skill that you can improve. It's just a chore that you have to endure, and you've got to hope that you get lucky. Really, it seems entirely random where the fruit appears. Anyway, here's the new incoming message. This story's gradually building. Here we go. Beware of false prophets, which come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly they are ravening wolves. Of course they are. Ye shall know them by their fruits. Do men gather grapes of thorns or figs of the thistles? Even so, every good tree bringeth forth good fruit, but a corrupt tree bringeth forth evil fruit. A good tree cannot bring forth evil fruit, neither can a corrupt tree bring forth good fruit. Every tree that bringeth not fruit, good fruit. What the hell? More Bible quotes. The problem is, like, quote the Bible all you like, but this isn't really teaching us a lesson, is it? I don't have a problem with you like using Bible quotes and philosophy and stuff in your games, as long as it's actually serving some sort of purpose. Okay. So anyway. Let's see what's next. A huge antimatter tribute is here. That means another boss battle. Oh, God, and it starts off with... and I haven't actually got a... I was pressing the wrong button. Done it. Please don't die. Please don't die! No! He was like inches from death. I've got to go through all of that again. He was so close to death. One thing this game does give you is a profound sense of loss when you lose. You know, it's not like an MMO or something where you die and it's just like, oh, respawn, off you go, go and do the same odd thing again. You know you've messed up, you know it, and you've got to do all that again, and it's like, ugh. Yeah, it's really bad. Right, okay, there we go, let's block that. Bongo Amoeba. I'm not entirely sure what that means. Right. Let's give it another go. Let's try and get through this. I reckon we can get through this. Someone's just told me that the game looks like someone made by someone on glue. Those of you who are 80s or 90s kids probably remember that sniffing glue was the cool thing to do when you were 13, supposedly, if you wanted to die. Okay, right, here we go. Now I'm hoping things are going to get a little bit better. I really don't know what the risk gauge is supposed to do, or how it sort of increases or anything like that. I mean, most of this stuff makes sort of sense, but I'm not sure what risk means. Is that how close to unleashing hell is going to be? Or oh, I see what you mean about the bongo guy. Yeah, it's I don't know what that is. No idea. Okay, right, here we go. So, let's go on the old quest for fruit. It's a good start. There's one right away. Let's just water that tree. Oh, come on! It's hugely unfair. Well then, I guess, as a bonus, there was like three pieces of fruit right there. Three pieces of fruit. Try saying that 10 times fast. That's fairly straightforward. I don't know if that whole, like, you know, the FMV bit, I don't know if that's their attempt at turning this into some sort of, like, 4chan creepypasta or something like that, you know. Like Sonic.exe. God damn it. So, just heard a beep from my dishwasher telling me the dishes have been done. How awesome is that? That is probably more interesting than this section of the game. I don't actually mind the shoot 'em up sections. They're not too bad. Yeah, I mean they're kind of basic and everything, but as far as gameplay goes, it isn't that bad. I like the graze mechanic. It's pretty fast paced. Don't really know much about the fruit as bullets thing, but you know, this section of the game though is like tedious in the extreme. I really hate it. That was fairly straightforward. And then we treated to the NCP car park again. Right, here we go. Hopefully, I'll do better this time. Even though I've only got, like, two lives left. I think this creature it's got a big crucifix on its face. I've never really noticed that before because I've been too busy looking at my own thing. Oh, I'm so gonna die. Ah! Oh! So close, though. Right, I think my tactic now is to just, like, properly focus on where I'm going. I'm not going to try and go for graze bonuses or anything like that while fighting the bosses. I'm just gonna try and avoid the bullets. I'm not even going to look where I'm shooting. I'm just going to keep on shooting, look at myself, and move around the bullets. I think that's the way to go. And then just hope I get lucky on the overland sections. Not entirely sure how big the hitbox is. I mean, I'm not sure how, because obviously if the things touch you, you get a graze bonus, so that the hitbox can't be like the full size of my sprite. Oh, balls. Oh no, I really wasn't looking then. I was looking at the boss's health. That's another thing I don't like, the UI design. It's kind of rubbish. You can't focus on one place and see all the information that you need. Oops, I'm out of water. Carrot. Oh, I need one more piece of fruit. There it is. Boing. Right. Right, okay, here we go. The other thing as well is the fact that the level progression is so uninspired. It's like, do one of those bosses, then do the boring overland section, then do another one of those bosses, and they're not really that different, you know, as far as gameplay goes. Oh, I messed that up pretty badly. That was unfair. Let's see if we can do the overland section again. Here we go. I think the frequency of the lightning gets higher, you know, the further into the game you get. One more piece of fruit though. Oh, lost a tree. Don't really care. There we go. I'm doing alright now. I think I've got like 2 or 3 lives left for this next boss. So as long as I don't totally cane it, I think I'm in with a good chance. Here we go. Okay.
That seemed easy that time. I don't know what it was. I don't remember Mayim. What is he? Some kind of omen? He says this is all some kind of a game. Oh god, look, it's breaking the fourth wall, just like Deadpool. He says he's from another reality. A deserted tower where the sirens go to die. That sounds like a pretty good place right now, you know. Oh, and off we go. These trees are going to die at a rate of knots, I reckon. This is... some more water. Getting the hang of those overland things. I've got to do another boss now as well, haven't I? Let's see what the message is this time. What Bible quotes are going to be? We have an altar whereof they have the right to eat which serve the tabernacle. Blah, 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 blah. Let us go forth, therefore, unto him without the camp bearing his blah, 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 blah. Another huge antimatter tribute. Here we go. Looks like you get all your smart bombs back at the start of each boss. Whoa, okay. Really is relentless, this one. A bit too late with that super smart bomb. Oh god, no. Please, 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 please! Yeah, Ash, I said that about the first game. No god would allow such a game to exist. The first game was actually a lot worse than this. This is an improvement, if you can believe that. It's not like one of those games that it's just like, oh god, you heard about this game? It's so rubbish they had to bury it in the desert. You know, like ET on the 2600. It's just boring. It's just not good. Establishing connection, brilliant. There's some binary there. Good. More binary. Keep grinding. I am close now. Well, I guess at least the game knows. At least the game knows what it's about. I'm probably going to die now and get sent back to the start, and I really don't have the will or the motivation to go through all of that again. So fingers crossed. The fire's getting a little bit saucy now as well, you know. Only need two more pieces of fruit though, so I don't know, I might do it. Oh, it's a bit of fire. Is there any fruit though? There's a piece. Yeah, this is the improved version. This is the sequel. What's going on in that FMV? This looks like a car. None of this makes sense. None of it makes sense. But I'm pretty sure I'm going to have to fight another one of those bosses. Do not unplug the Ethernet, and don't panic if your frame rate drops dramatically. The thing is, part of me wants to know where this story is going, even though I'm pretty sure it's going nowhere, but the other part of me really doesn't want to fight that boss and then die, which I'm blatantly going to do, and then have to go all the way back to the start. So, oh god, no, that's it. I'm literally a dead man walking, dead man playing. That's it. Well, I doubled my last score, which was good, but unfortunately there is no high score table, so the score becomes kind of pointless. Give them credit though, one of the things I said was bad about the first game was the fact that there's not even a score. At least now I've got a score. You get some sense of progress. It's better than the first game. It's not a good game. It's not an awful game. It's pretty awful. But I've played plenty worse games. It's certainly not worth $3.99. Maybe 39p. No, it's not worth 39p. If it was a free game, then yeah, that'd be all right. So yeah, I mean that's Uriel's Chasm 2. Now, as I said right at the start of the stream, I have a giveaway. I've got 4 keys so that you can either own this great game or you could gift it to your friends as a hilarious Christmas gift. I'm not entirely sure how to do this giveaway. I think the fairest way is for me to say, tell me why you shouldn't have this game. Tell me why you shouldn't have this game. And the worst answer to that question will win. The 4 worst answers to that question will win a key. So tell me why you shouldn't have this game. So it's in your best interest to come up with the best answer possible. I'm looking for things that are funny, insightful, philosophical, perhaps. But if you write something which is kind of terrible, you're probably going to get the thing. Now, the stream's about to come to an end. Probably the best way of doing this, rather than me announce the winners live on the stream, if I say you can put your answers in the live chat, or once the stream has been archived and put on YouTube, just put your answers in the comments, and then at the start of next week's stream, which I'm not entirely sure what it's going to be, I'll announce the winners of the giveaway, and then I'll contact you with your keys. So I don't know how close to the end of the game I was. I'm probably never going to play the game again. So maybe, you know, if you win the contest, or sorry, if you lose the contest, depending on your outlook, you can play the game and you can try and be better than me, and see how far you get. So, yeah, there we go. That was Uriel's Chasm 2. Not as bad. Once again, though, notice in the credits, there's not actually anyone credited as being a tester. So the game presumably was not tested. Now, I don't know whether this was actually a ROM hack or whether it was just created from scratch. And to be honest, I don't really care. It's not really worth anyone's time. That was Uriel's Chasm 2. So to be in with a chance of winning or not winning a key to Uriel's Chasm 2, just answer the question, why shouldn't you have a copy of the game?
And the worst answers will get a copy of the game, because honestly, that's what you deserve. Thanks very much for watching. I apologise to some of the childish outbursts that seem to happen in the group chat. I guess there's no accounting for foolishness on the internet. I tried to ban them, as I noticed. I won't tolerate racism or pointless idiocy. Obviously, as my stream gains popularity, that's going to become more frequent. But honestly, I don't really think it's going to gain that much popularity, because, you know, I've already shifted it to a different time slot. You know, I'm hoping that the stream ends up like the Firefly of gaming streams. You know, it's like broadcast. I should have started at episode 13, and then, you know, I'll change the time slot every single week, and then after about 12, 13 episodes, maybe I'll just end up like not doing any more. But it'll become a total cult classic, and people will cosplay as me when they go to gaming conventions. That's what I hope is going to happen to the stream. Next week, back to the normal time slot of Friday night, 7:30. If anyone's got any suggestions for a rubbish game to play, and if you want to gift me a rubbish game on Steam, leave a comment either in the live chat or in the comments when the thing goes live, or send me a direct message on Facebook, and we'll get sorted out. So thank you all again to watching. Again, I'd like to thank my potential future sponsors, Nong Shim, who make brilliant noodles, the Shin Cup noodles. So Nong Shim, if you're watching, please sponsor me, give me free noodles. Thanks for watching, thanks for commenting. Hope you've enjoyed it. I really haven't enjoyed the game, but I've enjoyed making you smile, I hope. So thanks everyone, I'll see you next time.